great to see a lot of familiar faces. I'm sure there's a lot of familiar faces on the live stream too. See, we do have chemistry.
Wir lieben Köln und bitte schaut auf Twitter und in den Foren nach Infos zum morgigen Pop-Up Party, falls ihr in der Nähe seid. Es wird ein lockeres Zusammenkommen.
I heard Twitter and Pop-Up Party. We really love Cologne. Please tune in on Twitter or the forums for tomorrow's pop-up gathering. If you're around, catch it.
Hello?
Is it a bomb?
Vielen Dank an die Freiwilligen. Wir würden das ohne euch nicht schaffen. Und zumindest meine Füße sind sehr dankbar für die ganze Hilfe auf dem Shopfloor. And I'm going to say that in English because it'd be weird for Ben to say that. Thank you so much to all our volunteers. We couldn't do this without you, and I certainly know that my feet are grateful for the help on the show floor.
Excuse me, may I just...
Ein kleiner Stand, der ziemlich belagert ist, in Halle 10.1 A33. So stop by if you haven't already. We're in a small booth, hall 10.1 A33.
Can I?
Yeah.
And it has been non-stop busy.
Excuse me?
Es ist nur ein kleiner Stand, da wir das Geld lieber für die Entwicklung ausgeben.
Could I?
Nächstes Jahr könnten wir ja vielleicht für einen Russlandstand crowdfunden.
Excuse me, I'm filming.
That is my favorite CIG employee, and he deserves a raise.
The cosplay as well.
We went small because, as you know, we're spending all our money on game development. So maybe next year we could crowdfund a nice booth.
360-degree camera, so we're filming everyone, and you're going to be back here in VR one day.
Wir danken auch unseren Partnern SciTech, Intel, Falcon Northwest und AMD. Von denen wir ein paar nette Mitbringsel und später in der Show noch eine Überraschung.
Could I pass through? I'm filming.
Thanks to our partners, SciTech, Intel, Falcon Northwest, and AMD. We have some fun giveaways and a surprise to show you later tonight.
Excuse me.
Vielen Dank an das ganze CIG-Team, das hier vor Ort ist. Wir freuen uns, den Abend mit euch zu verbringen.
Thank you also to the whole CIG team who is here.
Excuse me, may
We're
I pass
all excited
through?
To share tonight
everybody.
With you.
May I pass through? Yes. Yeah. Excuse me. May I pass through?
Wir haben sehr schwer gearbeitet, nicht nur für heute Abend, sondern auch für den Rest des Spiels. Daher bitte ich um einen großen Applaus für alle Mitarbeiter in allen unseren Studios. Know what was said, but I was thanking all of our CIG teams around the world for all of their hard work. Ein besonderer Dank geht im Namen unseres Teams an Chris Roberts und all unsere Fans, die das alles hier ermöglichen. Last but not least, I would like to thank Chris Roberts and all of our fans on behalf of our team for making this possible. Roberts für seine endlosen Stunden, in denen er programmiert und Regie führt und ein Projekt realisiert, das so bahnbrechend ist wie dieses hier. Und an die Fans überall in der Welt, die mit uns diesen Traum verwirklichen, indem sie Star Citizen unterstützen. For countless hours that Chris has been coding and directing and realizing on a project as groundbreaking as this, and to all of our fans around the world who are making this dream possible by supporting Star Citizen.
Well, first, I'm going to have one more person that I like. Thank you, Sandy. Nobody works as hard as Sandy Gardiner. So thank you also. And without further ado,
the man himself, Mr. Chris Roberts.
I think a really great show for you. Fingers crossed. And thank you for surviving the heat and warmth here, because this is, I spent time in Texas, Austin, which is very hot, and obviously it's hot in California too. And I would say this is pretty much about as hot as I've ever been in here. So thank you for being packed and surviving out. We've got a very good show for you here. So I actually have a few people that are going to help me with part of the demos we're going to show you tonight. So I'm going to bring up some of the group here. So here we come. There's someone that I occasionally call my brother, Eric. We have Andrew Singleton, who's the head of our UK QA. UKQA, Leo, UKQA, Ken, UKQA, Dan, Desire in our new Frankfurt office, Ron to help us, and where's Paul? I'm just Paul, is he hiding back here? He's getting beat, alright. We have Paul Rendell, who's our lead engineer. Who's getting beer, so he'll be here very soon. So, if you guys take a seat, and hopefully Paul will be up here in a second. Here he comes, and here's Paul Rendell, who needed a beer. Right, so, we've got quite a few things to show you today. Having quite fun here at Gamescom. We've shown some of the stuff to the press early so they could see it, and I think they're fairly impressed, we'll see, and I'm hoping you guys will like the stuff that we show you too. So we'll start at the beginning. We're calling crewing up because we're talking about the multi-crew part of the game, which is sort of my big dream, has always been what I've wanted. My friends, walk around, use, do that. So that's going to be towards the back half of this demo. But let's just sort of start with where we're at. So we just, I think, went. See, red one, what's your status? So we just went live 1.16, I believe, yesterday. So that has 16 players. You can play multiplayer. I think 1.15 had that too.
We have the SAG in the middle, Fireball. There's a new launcher at 1.16, which is much better, much faster than the old launcher, and more reliable. I think, in fact, it's almost too fast for some people. It takes all the bandwidth, so we're working on fixing that. And we have a much better back-end manager that we're still working on improving, but it's built to be much more scalable for the use that we're going to need for this social module, the FPS, and the persistent universe. So it's sort of laying the foundation for what we're doing there. And, that's a Ben Lesnick pun there, fits like a glaive. So in the new 1.16, we have a special mode. We've made Vandal Swarm much, much more difficult. And you've got clear, I think, is it 20 waves? 18 waves? And if you do, you will be able to get a special badge to fly a glaive, which you can get with correct purchase. And I think we're saying the first 1,000 that manage to finish it, then they will also be able to either use rec or purchase it by store credit or whatever they want to do. So I don't think we've had anyone in RQA manage to do it yet, right? So no one in RQA has managed to clear all those waves, so let's see who's going to do it out there. I'm sure there's quite a few people that managed to do that. But it's kind of a fun little competition we decided to do with it. So it's a little bit of a surprise for you. We are going to be releasing the social module expansion this month. So this is going to come out. It's sort of the very basic start of it, but it's going to allow you to leave your hangar, walk around our first planet side environment, which is Art Corp on Saturn 4, I think, and interact, move around, and actually meet up with other people. So I think we're looking to support at least 20 players moving around the Art Corp environment, and it's your first sort of step into the larger persistent universe world. So we'll sort of show it very quickly here. And Jared, switch to the, you should have stayed on the other screen. There you go. See, we're just trying to get our timing going earlier, but sorry it took so long. What's that? Yeah, you like loading screens? I'm waiting for the spin up. Let's see what else we've got going in the social module. You'll be able to chat, you'll be able to do emotes, we'll show you that in a bit. Go between your hangar and the Art Corp area and also Arena Commander. Are we up yet? Okay. So here we are. This is sort of in, this is in the elevator you take up from your hangar. And where we start is, which everyone will be able to do in a couple of weeks, we'll be in the customs area of Art Corp. And for the very first release of the social module, we don't have all the variation in clothes, so it'll be mostly the outfits that we have for the FPS level. But the next couple of releases, we're actually going to be switching where you'll be able to customize your clothes and do stuff. So, yeah, there's, you know, some silly little things you can chat. You can also do various emotes and goof around. You can chat, do emotes, let's head in and just do a bit of sightseeing. Alright, Andrew, so let's head off. So, I think Andrew just stepped through sort of where the customs entry would be when you actually, if you go back out, let's just go and take a look at where the landing pad is so people can know where we're coming from. So stay with red one, Jared, please. So we just go back over here. Out there is in the final game, when you're landing in the Citizen Universe, you would land down here. You would come in here, this is the customs area, and then we would head through the sort of security or you know whatever you want to call it, sort of customs immigration, which is through here, which normally, depending on the environment, it would sort of determine whether you were wanted or not wanted. So if this is a lawful UEE area, if you're an outlaw, they probably wouldn't let you come in or land. Maybe they would, it sort of depends on where you're going. Also, if you weren't allowed to bring weapons in, this is where you'd have to sort of leave and deposit them, or leave them back on your ship. And then you would go out here into our port. So here we are. Hey, Jared, just stay with Red One, please, don't switch. So here we are, we're in the main plaza of Area 18. I think Andrew, is anyone around near you? You could probably just show them the AR where they can sort of see the names of the other people over them if you want to do the AR, right? So you can switch AR on, you'll be able to use Moby Glass in later events, so that's how you can sort of know who the various people are. These are all our various sort of demo accounts for this. And let's head off to, let's go to Cubby Blast. So we'll sort of do a quick tour of the different locations. So these are all sort of the basic shop types that you're going to encounter in the Persistent Universe. Most of them are represented here in Art Corp. They'll be obviously very different looks and styles, different brands, different shops. This is Cubby Blast, where you would come to buy your personal weapons. Again, you'll be able to put your AR on, see the different items, transact and buy through your Moby Glass. In V0, you won't be able to buy and sell. I think our V1 and V2 release of the social module Persistent Universe will have persistence in the background database. So we need to shift. So right now, when you go into the hangar and you go into Arena Commander, it populates your ships based on what's on your weather count. But for a proper, full sort of online experience, you need a Persistent Universe. A persistent database to store off your state, what you're wearing, you know, every little item you've changed, moved around, and I think we're doing that in the first or second revision of the social model. Okay, so let's head out and look at a few other places. Across the way is the medical unit. You're the big heavy one. So this is essentially the kind of place that you would come. So if you got killed in space, or you would recover in a recovery room in here and come out, this is also where you can come to buy various sort of medical healing devices. So stim packs, med packs, all the sort of things you would need if you got into FPS combat, boarding a ship out in the Persistent Universe of the world. And in the sort of V1 of the social module, which is the next release after this one, there'll be a whole bunch of AI moving around, going about their schedules. In this first release, it will just be other players and you sort of playing around the environment. Right, so let's head up over here. We can go in and take a look at the job well. So here's the Art Corp job well. This is sort of the official place that you would go to look for jobs in the Persistent Universe. Essentially, I've talked about a mission system and a mission board. This is sort of the official place for that, where people put up jobs to haul cargo from, say, Art Corp to another planet, or be an escort for a cargo run, or have a mercenary assignment, or basically look for bounty hunter assignments, or generally what's happening. And again, this would be full of NPCs, and can sort of see a lot of, and that's kind of the terminals you would interact with back there. And big Art Corp set up behind there.
Thank you!
For the Constellation, potentially flown by some sketchy pilots, we don't know yet. We may meet them later. So let's head out of here and go to the other sort of place that you would probably go to look for missions, which would be the bar.
Oh,
So here we are, this is the G-Log bar, and again, you know, most of our locations, depending on where you are, we have actually quite a few planet side environments that we've built. This is the first one we're sort of showing you, but we've done several that have different styles, different architecture styles. You know, Terra is you know, obviously a much more sort of super modern kind of setup. We have a Nyx, which is more of a sort of outlaw asteroid city. Yeah, we can do some dancing. Dance! Okay, I think it's enough for the dancing. So, and there's also going to be other areas to sort of explore most of our planet side environments. So this is an example of sort of like a back alleyway, and we're sort of going to have areas that, even though we may not have PvP combat down on the planet side environments, we'll definitely have some level of PvE interaction. So you could go down the back alleyway, and you could get mug perhaps, or this is, or here's the incinerator for the sort of Art Corp area. So potentially you could do some shady deals back here, or they could be fairly dangerous, or you go around here, there's sort of like a kind of backdoor, I don't know whether you want to call it a speakeasy, but it'd be somewhere you would go to get sort of more gray missions, let's put it that way, down that way. So let's go up the stairs here to sort of show the rest of the location. And again, so as we move on, we'll be building this out with a lot of NPCs as well as just other players moving around. And here's another sort of sense of the scope of scale that we're trying to do for our planet side environments. And I think it's kind of a Armada, which is where we buy a ship. But this is sort of very much about, you know, with us, yes, it's taking a bit of time, but we're really trying to craft.
Okay,
we're really trying to craft the world, so they're all sort of feel lived in, real places, with their stories. We're doing stuff, some of the conversation system stuff that we developed for Squadron 42 is going to come into the Position Universe, and will sort of enable us to sort of tell stories in this universe, and sort of let you adventure around it in a way that maybe you hadn't before. Certainly not the way you had to be able to do it in freelancer or a privateer. So here's Astromata, which is sort of a high-end sort of ship dealership. You know, one thing that I would like to say, that in the Persistent Universe, on you know, not every ship, not every dealer, not every shop has every item you can get. So you'll have to travel around the universe, and some places is where you know, like for instance, you probably won't be able to buy an M50 everywhere, or certain kinds of weapons. And so hopefully it will force people to move around the universe to sort of buy the items they want, or find or explore the items. And so just, you know, like you can in the real world, there'll be things that are unique to locations that you can go around and do. All right, let's just step out of here and see the last location that's in the Art Corp environment. And there's actually one that I haven't shown you because it isn't fully finished yet, but down there is Casper Outlet, and that's actually where you're going to go to buy clothes so you can customize your appearance, which is down there. But Andrew, let's just go to Dumpers Depot. So there's the Casper Outlet that you would go. Dumpers Depot is right by the Astro Armada where you left. So you're going to have to run back. Lots of running. But generally, the idea is obviously that you wouldn't just be running around to locations, we're just trying to show you everything. But you'd be going around meeting other players, talking to other NPCs. Generally having a good time. I think Andrew's a bit tired right now. That's why he's not running so fast. He's lost his stamina.
I got
Ben on it. Ah, now he's picked up his stamina. Depot would be the place in Artcom you'd come to buy ship items, which you can sort of see to the left. Andrew moves to there, that'll be all the ship items you can see out there. You'd buy them with the terminal over here, and then you can also have your ship repaired, which is sort of what's happening back there with the Hornet in the background. Okay, so that's sort of a brief tour of the Artcom environment. So let's go on to the back to the presentation first. There we go. So anyway, that's the social module for you, and the alcohol demo that we gave you.
Oh, sure, yeah.
So that's going to be the end of this month. Star Marine will be hopefully the end of next month. I know it's a little longer than I said a few weeks ago. I'm going to show you part of it now. We've sort of been consistently doing animation. So our biggest issue with Star Marine is getting the first person and third person animations to work seamlessly. So I'll show you some stuff here that I think looks really quite good. But the big challenge, and I think this has sort of been talked about a lot, is for us, we can't cheat. So a lot of first person shooters are only in first person mode, so you can sort of have the hands around the camera here. And if you sort of look at something like Call of Duty, when you're actually interacting with the environment in the first person, you see all these really great animations, but it's all specifically designed with sort of a sort of fake first person view. And if you notice, when you go into the multiplayer version of Call of Duty and you see the other players running around, you don't nearly have the same fluidity of animation that, say, the AI does in the single player mode. And they don't really, the other players don't really interact with the environment the same way that you would do in sort of the first person sort of kind of roller coaster sequences that happen in, say, Call of Duty. And so for us, the problem is not so much the FPS, because we could sort of do the same kind of things, but in the full persistent universe, you can be flying a ship and having someone sit right next to you, and he's got his hands on the controls, interacting with the panels, interacting with the environment, and so you will always see other players in third person, even if you only are in first person, interacting with the environment. So that basically means that we have to make third person and first person all sort of work from the same base, which is the most difficult thing to sort of do in first person games. People will tell, lots of first person developers will say that. Armor 3 does unify the two of them, and we are unifying, so we're pretty confident that we're going to make it work, but it is taking a little longer. In the last sort of stages, we're sort of retrofitting the skeleton to do a little bit better in terms of the ragdoll physics, which unfortunately, when we retrofit the skeleton, it means we have to retarget the animations. We have about 3,000 animations, so it takes a little bit of time. Having said all that, I think already looks great, and I think ultimately it's going to be work really well and be fun, and it is foundational in the game. So the social module I just showed you, in fact I actually should have done it, we should have just put a loadout, but you can actually switch to a full FPS loadout and have a gun and shoot other people in it, because everything, when you're running around, there's no difference in our code base, it is the same code base. So all the stuff you're seeing, the social stuff you're seeing, the FPS you're seeing, will all be in multi-crew that we're releasing a little later on. So here we are, we're just going to go to FPS, show around. I've got six of the guys here. And I'm going to, hopefully Jared's going to cut around and make it slightly interesting, we'll see. and I think we want to sort of show, are we on Reds? Who are we on right now? Red one. Okay. You want to go show a little bit of the animation on the back there before we get into some combat? Andrew? So I'll just have Andrew pop out to third person view. There you go. Maybe show, you want to sort of kind of So like several things that we're trying to do is we're sort of trying to have real sort of like motion and inertia. So if you notice when you move around, it's like if I've got a gun and I'm going like this, I'm gonna do this as I'm doing. That's the natural way. And if you're gonna shoot, you always should have to be like that. So because if you sort of start to shoot like this, you're gonna lose your balance. So we're trying to model that with this. And we have a sort of, hopefully a fluidity of animation that you don't normally see. I mean, you certainly don't do it most of the time in a first person shooter because you don't have to worry about the animation, but these are all things that we're working on to make the experience sort of realistic and also look cool when other people are doing it. And we're also sort of focusing on making the combat more tactical if we possibly can, because in the persistent universe, Star Marine is going to be sort of like like Arena Commander, where it's sort of a bit simpler shooter, you can respawn, but in the actual combat mechanics in the persistent universe, you aren't going to be able to respawn. You're sort of going to start back on whatever planet you were last on. And so we sort of need to make the animation and set combat a little better. So let's get into that center area and perhaps shoot each other and see that. Show the electric shotgun's always a fun one to use. Yeah, that's the electric shotgun. Yeah, don't show the replacement texture there, guy. So some of the things that we're still working on is the sort of the fidelity of the hits. When you can feel, you can get hit the animation for that. So we don't have that in yet, so you should be able to feel the impact. Also, we have specific limb damage, so you can be wounded in your leg and you'll limp around, or you can have your arm shot and then you can only use a one-handed weapon instead of a two-handed weapon. So we're trying to have a lot of sort of precision, some of the same stuff that we have for the ships. And all that stuff takes a little bit. We can nail the back. Yeah, that's kind of cheap. Also, use a couple of the hologram, the gadgets. You guys want to use the gadget stuff? It should be... Use G as a... I think it would be... Whoever's playing the heavy can have hologram. Anyone a heavy marine? Aaron, you're heavy. If you hit G, it should deploy a hologram. Oh, someone just got shot. So here, on red, can you go to red 4? Jared? Aaron's dead. Sorry. Right, I was trying to show some gadgets. So the heavy marine's got the hologram gadget. Which is G. Yeah, who's got a heavy marine? It's not. It sounded like someone did something. That's a shield. So that's a shield gadget you can do for deployable cover.